Welcome back. We are covering sections as a topic. And in this video, we are going to create a proper professional formal document, which looks like this. We want the cover page to be vertically centered. Second, I want table of contents to have Roman numbering. And that should, of course, start with one. On page 3, the actual content is starting. But I want the page numbering to be page 1. In addition to that, I also want to display the chapter, current chapter, in the header. So let's get started. This is how my base document is. Now, first things first, I want to display the section numbers. Yes, I can see sections at the bottom, but I want to put it inside the footer. So just double click in the footer area. And now we'll go to insert, quick parts and fields. Field is like a variable. One of them is the current section number. Insert that field. It's too small, so I'm going to increase the size. In real life, you're not going to need this. This is because we are learning. I want to show the section number. Double click in the main body to close footer. If you want to have different page numbering, you need different sections. So where do we want different numbering? Cover page, we don't want numbering. TOC, we want. I'm going to insert a section and new page. Layout, break, new section, new page. Immediately after cover page. Let's do the same thing just before actual content starts. So now you can see very clearly section 1, 2, 3. Great. Now usually whatever is in the cover page has to be vertically centered. So go to the page setup. Layout. There is something vertical alignment by default top. Make it center. That's it. Now let's talk about page numbers. We have headers and we have footers. The page numbering is completely separately customizable for header and footer. So we have already put section number in footer and that's going across all pages as expected. But when it comes to this header, we want some customization. So let me show you what happens by default. Double click, open the header. Whatever I type here goes across all sections and that's by design. Generally, it's a good thing. For example, for sections, this was good. But in the header case, we don't want that to happen. Now, how do you tell Word, whatever I do here should not get transmitted across all sections? So these sections are linked. So look at this. This is section 1 header. This is section 2 header, section 3 header, and so on. And all of them are linked. I want to break the link between section 2 and section 1 header. And this is the setting, link to previous. This is the toggle on or off. And currently what is the setting is shown here, same as previous. Now the moment I click link to previous, is going to be off. Off for section 2 header. And now same as previous is gone. Let's type something. So now section 1 is independent of section 2 in simple terms. I also want to break the link between 2 and 3. Fair enough. So again, I delete this, go to section 3, say don't link to previous. Now whatever I type here will be only for section 2. So now let's finish off the page numbering for TOC. Well, I decide that it should be right aligned. I want it in header. And the moment you say top of page and you'll say right align, it'll replace whatever you have written there. That's not the right way. You have already written something. So you want the page number to go wherever your current position is. So now this doesn't give you too many options. Simple plain number and it'll get added to whatever you have written. Okay, so far so good. But I don't want this thing to start as Roman number. No problem. I go to format page number. And by default, actually, it'll have continued from previous. And it would be page 2 because it's physically page 2. But that's easy. Go to format page number, say start at 1. And while we are at it, might as well make it Roman numbering. Custom numbering for a table of contents, which is starting from number 1, irrespective of what is there before. Now let's talk about numbering for actual content itself. Sure, this time I'll make it left aligned, just to show you a variation. Again, I'm going to type the word page. If it is continue from previous section, it'll be 2 because previous section we have pre-started at 1. We don't want that. We want to start at 1. And of course, we want regular Roman numbers. Very good. Now, all these numbers are nicely going across pages. But if it is a really formal document, if you have seen in books as well, the first page where the actual content starts doesn't show the page number. It is counted as page one, but the page number itself becomes visible from page two. That means page one, first page, is given a different treatment. Sure. So that's why we have an option here called different first page. The moment you do that, first page gets a separate header footer and page two continues. You already know what to do with landscape pages. So I'm going to go before the landscape area, go to layout, inside a break, next page. I'm going to go to after the table, again insert a next page break. And while it has its own section, I'm going to simply make it landscape. Now notice what happened. Landscape page doesn't seem to have page numbering or even section numbering for that matter. Why did that happen? Let's go to the header of this. And because earlier was different first page, this carried forward the different first page. But for this guy, we don't want different first page. When that happens, section is carrying forward. Page numbering again is getting stuck. So now we say page number. This time we want to continue from previous section. And now it works as expected. Now this one also has misbehaved because of that first page. So we have to repair this a couple of times, but you get the idea. So you should create all the sections down the document first and then make first page different. That way, this manual repetitive work is eliminated. And now almost everything is done except this. I want three columns here and you already know how to do that. Layout, breaks, continuous break. One in the beginning and one at the end of that long list. And then go inside the list which has multiple columns. So do that. And our job is done. The last thing I want to show you is in the page header, along with the page numbering, I want the chapter number to come. For this to work, all the chapters or headings should be marked as heading one. For example, warranty here is heading one. Summary here is heading one. So you go to insert, quick parts field, look for something called style ref. On this page, wherever heading one is applied, take the first item and show it to me. So you say style ref heading one. Heading one means main topic. So in this case, heading one is warranty. Also, there is support, which is heading one, but the first one which encounters on that page, and that is how you create professional documents by using all the knowledge we have about sections. Watch the entire series so that you know exactly how to manage page layout for all kinds of documents. And that's it for now. Thank you.